Have you ever created a button in your Power BI report using Power Automate, but it doesn't work for anybody else than you? Watch this video to learn how to enable it for others. Hello everyone, Shab is here with another interesting video. And today I'm going to talk about the settings you should know when working with Power Automate Instant Cloud Flows in Power BI. You should know about this setting, otherwise your flows may affect. If it's the first time you're watching my videos, hit the subscribe button to get the notification for the new upcoming videos. Follow me on LinkedIn and read Power BI articles on my blog. Stay tuned. After publishing some tutorials about Power Automate use cases in Power BI, I received a question. Hello, it worked perfectly for me, thank you. For final users, I granted access to the dataset. But one end user is reporting that the refresh is unsuccessful. Any idea how to solve the issue? Thank you. In this video, I will not only describe how to resolve this issue, but also we'll talk about a few other features that you may need when dealing with Instant Cloud Flows. Let me open this report that we previously created. If you remember, on this report, we created this button here, and using it, we could send the selected information in this table in form of a CSV file to whoever pressed the button. If you haven't watched this tutorial yet, you can click on the link on top right and learn how to create it. Now consider we have this report with this Power Automate button on it. But after a while, we received some new requirements for the project, and we need to apply some changes. So, how can we do that? It's very easy. You need to just click on the visual, and from here, click on these three dots and press on edit. In this new window, as you remember, from this part you can see the previously created flows. I'm always insisting on choosing a proper name for your flows before save and apply the flows. Because if one day you want to come back and edit, it's easy for you to find it here, from the list of flows. Okay, in our report we created a button to send the info as a CSV file to our users. As you can see here, I previously chose this name, create CSV file for our flow. And I know between these two flows, I should edit this one. First, when I hover my mouse on these flows, you can see a toggle selection button will appear for us. It helps us to change the flow for our current button. It means I can change the functionality of our button by moving from this one, as an example, to this one. For now, I choose our current flow again. When selected, on the right-hand side, you can see a couple of options. This tick mark is the apply button. When I click on it, this flow will be applied to our button. Beside it, you can see a bin, which helps us to delete the flow whenever required. Then here, you can see a pencil icon. And if I click on it, the flow will be appeared for you. And now is the time you can apply any changes on your report. For example, you can add some other steps and save the CSV file on SharePoint or OneDrive. After applying any changes, we can simply click on Save and Apply, and we'll go back to the report. For now, I just click on this back button to go back to the previous page. When we click on it, instead of going back to the previous page, this page will be open for us, in which we can apply some other changes. But we can also open this window from the first page. So let me go back to the report and start from the scratch by pressing edit option on the visual. Here are again our flows. I choose this second one. And at the right end, you can see these three dots. Here you can see some options. I described edit and delete. You can also save as this flow with a new name, or just turn it off and disable it without deleting. At the end of this list, you can see details. If I click on it, you can see the same window that we opened a minute ago will appear for us. Within the details section, you can see the information about this flow, when it was created or modified, what its type, its status, owners, and so on. And below it, you can see how many times it was running successfully or failed with the duration info. Within the connection section, it shows us the connections to this flow. For example, for me, it's connected to Power BI and Office 365 Outlook. In the next section, you can press on Edit and add other owners to it. It is highly probable that you need to add your team members as owners for the maintenance. Or maybe you need to hand over your project to someone else. And finally, the important section that our friend asked at the beginning of this video, run-only users. When we create an instant cloud flow, we, as the owner of the flow, are the only users who can run it. And if anybody else presses the button, it fails for them. Let's click on Edit. Here is where we can add other users' emails and give them the ability to press the button. We can add users' emails or Azure AD Group's email. Both are working here. This setting also has another useful point, which is the security for our data. It means that if anybody else except the people we define presses the button, it fails for them. So next time you create a button using Power Automate, don't forget to define who can press it. And it's all about settings you need to know for the instant cloud flows on Power BI. Hope you enjoyed this video and appreciate to like and share it. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button to get a notification for the new upcoming videos. You can follow me on LinkedIn and read Power BI articles on my blog. Have a good day, all Power BI.